All right, so here we are in the Windows XP virtual machine. Now this is actually the same VM that I had created for Microsoft Plus for Windows XP, which we took a look at over a year ago. So we're gonna kind of see how Plus for Windows XP and Plus Digital Media Edition work like interchangeably with each other, which I'm not really sure if we're gonna see any of that, but you know, we might see like some programs from each kind of, you know, work together. But again, we're going to be taking a look at just Digital Media Edition in this video. If you want to see the Microsoft Plus XP video, I'll have a link down below and a YouTube cards to come on screen right now in the top right that you can, you know, go to that video. So yeah, let's just get started. We're going to go in to the now again, this is actually in my you know, host PC's drive here, so the loading times are not going to be, you know, like more instant as with an ISO file, because it's not really loading from anything except for the hard drive, which is obviously faster than, you know, the CD drive typically. But we're just going to click on install plus, and we're going to get a Windows installer here. We're going to actually go to the custom installation. We're going to go to I accept the terms of this license agreement. And we have the privacy statement last updated July 2003. So that kind of gives us an age of this, you know, product, because it was released in 2003, which was, I think, 2 years after XP and XP Plus. So we're going to click on this box right here to say that we have reviewed and agreed to this whole privacy statement. I mean, this is a really long privacy statement, but okay, we'll click on next. You see that it's gonna make a new folder, Digital Media Edition, and here's all the stuff that we got. And this is a lot of you know, programs. We're gonna get into all these later, but we're gonna make sure that they all are here. So we're gonna click next and click on install. It hasn't asked me for the product key yet, which is kind of odd, as I thought that, I have no idea. I actually thought that, didn't Plus for Windows 95 have a product key? I don't know if it did, because it says on the wiki that this is the first Plus version to include activation. Maybe it means like activating through a Microsoft server, I'm not really sure. But there is a product key on the back here, and it hasn't asked me for it yet, so we're gonna see how that goes. Because I could have sworn that we used a product key for that. Okay, here we go. So welcome to Microsoft Plus activation. I think this is what it meant. So I'm sorry for my statement before where I said that it's the only one that has product keys, because I'm pretty sure that Plus for 95 and 98 and XP all had like their own product keys. They just didn't, I guess, activate it. This is actually going to activate it online, I think, very similar to Windows XP. All right, so we have the whole product key entered here. We're gonna click next, and it actually, I guess, oh, cannot complete the Plus activation. I'm guessing that's because Plus activation, it says it's unable to transmit the information to Microsoft. Verify that your computer is connected to the internet. And hopefully it won't have to act this. Hopefully it won't make us activate it, because I think the servers are down for this. I believe they are for Windows XP, and if they're down for Windows XP, I'm pretty sure they're down for you know, like a Windows XP based product. So we're gonna click yes to restart the VM here, and we'll be back and see if everything works out. So I'm just gonna let this reboot, and I'll be right back. Okay, so we're back, and we now have Microsoft Plus Digital Media Edition activated. I actually had to call Microsoft and go through the whole like phone activation thing, because the thing, like, you know, to, I guess, activate it like over the internet on their servers wasn't working. Probably because the activation servers for this program were down, but the phone, you can still activate it over the phone. So if you do find this, you can obviously, you know, activate it over the phone. I tried to record the whole phone thing, but for some reason I didn't press the like resume button on the actual like software that I'm using to capture my screen. And I only got like the tail end of not really like the conversation, because it was just like automated system that was just asking me to, like, you know, enter all these numbers and then reading me something back. So yeah, but Anyway, yeah, now we have Microsoft Plus Digital Media Edition activated. So we're going to click on next here. We're going to click on, yeah, sure, we're going to register this with Microsoft. Why not? They can see somebody's using Microsoft Plus Digital Media Edition. And here we are. We have opened up Plus Photo Story 2. And, oh, are we not on the network here? Oh, well, that's probably why the freaking... You know, it would help if I actually plugged in a network cable on the computer. What? That's probably why I wasn't able to connect to to the phone server or to the. I'm sure the activation servers aren't down. Oh my gosh. Okay. Or maybe they are. I have no idea. But that was totally stupid of me. Oh my gosh. I'm so sorry. I just wasted so much time doing that, okay. Alright, so here we are in Microsoft Plus Photo Story 2. And like I said, I think this is going to be very similar to Windows Movie Maker, but we're going to see kind of what it is. So we're going to click on Begin a Story, and we're going to import some pictures. So let's just get some sample pictures from... Yeah, well, there's only this many. Yeah, we'll just grab these, because that's all we have. So we'll import these pictures. We're going to narrate our story, so I'm going to do an awesome narration here. All right. The hills in the background were blue, and you could see the clouds. That's great. All right, next photo. The sunlight looked as if sun was going down over whatever the heck that is. All right, next one. The flowers looked purple. Next one. The winter forest thing looked cool. All right, stop. We'll click on next. We're going to type a title. MJD's awesome video. And then the description will be author Michael. And then number of seconds to display, we'll do 7 seconds. We'll add this awesome Blue Hills title image. Okay, yeah, music file. We actually do have some of the music that I demoed in the other Microsoft Plus video, so we got this. We'll go to the desktop, and we'll get this, and we'll, I guess like that, preview final story. High quality, sure, we'll save in my videos. Is there just no sound in this? I don't understand what... All right, view story. There's no sound. What's going on? Hang on. All right. Well, we're gonna try updating VMware tools. If the sound doesn't work, and that's kind of an issue because I think a lot of the things that we're gonna demo involve sound. So I'm gonna get this working, and I'll be right back. All right, so we're back, and we have sound working, so I'm guessing that VMware Tools just needed that little update. So we're gonna see here. I'll turn up the volume, and then we have now like the nice background music, and you can like barely hear my voice, like the background music goes a lot over, so I'm sure that can be edited, but horrible narration. So it just kind of is so that you, like, it makes it easy for you to like narrate, like write over, you know, pictures really easy. So like if you were doing, I guess, like a business presentation, this could be used for that. But this was really used for like home videos, really. So like to make like a quick, easy home video with like, you know, adding in some like nice background music and, you know, things like that. Then like adding in, you know, your voice or, you know, someone else's voice to kind of, I guess, describe the picture that you're looking at. That's basically what this is for. And again, we can open this up, and this will actually open it in, it's a .psc file, which is a photo story document. So we can open this back up and, you know, add more things to it. So we can delete the actual narration down here. We can add more pictures, you know, things like that. So yeah, that is what Photo Story is basically. Kind of an interesting program. Again, it's kind of like a really basic version of Windows Movie Maker. But I guess if somebody didn't really want to go through the hassle of kind of dealing with, because Windows Movie Maker can be complex for some people, even though it is like a really basic piece of software, or one of the basic like editing softwares. It can still take time to go through and like edit everything. So this could be for somebody that doesn't want to deal with all that and just wants to get their photos in and make a small little movie out of it. So yeah, that's essentially what that is. We'll head on over into Plus Party Mode now. That's the next one on the wiki list here. So let's actually just open up this tour here because I'm just gonna kind of go through. Okay, so now we have sound in this. So we got like this nice, I guess, music soundtrack there. And we got some sound effects. Let's hope it doesn't do this the entire time. Okay, good. So next is party mode. So this is, it's gonna turn your computer into a party jukebox with this full screen scan for Windows Media Player. Party mode lets your computer and your desk. Party mode lets your computer and your guests become the DJ while restricting access to files and personal information on the computer. It also has new effects and features, including visual song title announcements and an interactive guest book for everyone at your party to enjoy. So I'm guessing we're gonna need some songs for this. So let me just go to my music folder on my computer here, and we'll copy over some songs. Let's find some. I'll get a few here. We'll get. We already have local forecast. We'll get. All right, so I just copied over these four songs right here. So I'm guessing we're gonna have to add these to like its own little playlist or something like that. So let's just open up Plus Party Mode. Plus Party Mode for Windows Media Player. So it sounds like this is gonna take control of your entire computer, because it says it includes options to let you control the amount of access guests have to your media library. So. We'll click OK. So we can have this option to block access to the desktop and other programs while party mode is running. And when turned to log on screen, party mode quits. So, yeah, so that's kind of interesting. We'll actually just leave that off for now, and then we'll try it again afterwards, or like after we exit party mode. So we have a few different skins here that come bundled. We have the basic party mode skin. We have butterflies, crystal clockwork, darkling, I think. So yeah, darkling nature, plasma and sunburst. We'll do let's do this one here. This one looks pretty cool, the plasma one. So we can have a crossfading in. We'll turn that on. We'll change visualization with each track. We'll display it start and finish the track information. And we'll do all music. So I'm actually just going to drag this into my music library, because that's probably what it's going to. We'll get rid of this WMA file and we'll drag the MP3 for local forecast in there. So we got five songs right here. We can edit a marquee text. So we'll say "Hello World" without the O capitalized. Apply and OK. Guests can add comments to the marquee. So that'll seem pretty cool. So yeah, let's just start the party and we'll see what happens. So yeah, here we are. We got all these different controls. We can click on play up here and it's playing the Highway Blues song that is comes bundled with Windows XP. It's like one of the standard music things. So we can show the equalizer here. We can show the playlist. Show visualizations, which I guess it's only like, actually, you know what? This probably wasn't made for like a 1080p monitor, as I usually always say with these older pieces of software. So I'm sure everything wouldn't be this small, like over on the right. It would probably be a lot larger, but it's just like really upscaled for this monitor. So we'll actually change. I actually don't know if this song is copyrighted. I might have to cut it out, but. Which I think I'm able to do, but let's just. All right, so Camtasia just decided to crash again. I don't know why it keeps doing that. It did that like in another video, but what I was trying to do is how to get or how to change the song, like, 'cause it was in this folder right here, and I want it to be in all music, but I have more than just these two. But yeah, that's essentially what plus party mode is. And so we're gonna stop the party, but let's actually see if we turn this on and we start the party. So if we click the X up here, yeah, it is actually going to kick us back to the login screen that we're gonna have to sign back in. So yeah, an interesting way, I'm guessing you can, like, it makes your PC into like a like sort of a music jukebox, kind of, as it, you know, lets really anybody use it, but you can restrict access to your personal files if you don't want people that, like, just to, you know, click the X in the corner and get back to your desktop and, you know, like, mess with your computer. I guess this would be useful if you brought, like, your laptop computer to, you know, somebody's house and you wanted to, like, leave it with somebody to manage the music or, you know, something like that. I'm sure it has, you know, many uses, but yeah, so the party is over, sadly. We're going to click yes. But yeah, that is what plus party mode is. Next we have the plus analog recorder, and this is going to allow us to take old tapes and vinyl records into the digital age, as it puts it right here. It converts analog sources into digital files on your computer with automatic hiss and pop reduction, track splitting, and more, so you can get more out of your exciting music collection. So this actually seems like a really useful program, even to some people, you know, probably today. I'm sure that there's, you know, like, you know, better tools for doing this nowadays, but you know, this could probably still be used. So we're gonna open up a plus analog recorder here. So we'll go into start plus analog recorder. Yeah, I don't really think I'm gonna be able to demo this really well because I don't really have like any old vinyl records laying around. I think I have some old cassette tapes somewhere, but I really don't have an idea where those are. They're probably up in my attic somewhere. But so yeah, I'm probably not gonna be able to actually give you a demo of what this would sound like, you know, unfortunately, but I can kind of show you like what it would actually do, or like how you would actually, you know, go about doing it. So, you know, what it asks you to do here is just select the actual sound device and then the input the input channel. So you can do like, you know, all of these, like, you know, different channels on your computer. So if you wanted to do something from your CD, you could, like, I guess rip the audio from a CD. Or you have, I think if you were doing something like a vinyl record, you would use like the line in on the back of your computer if you have one of those. I'm not sure if everybody does, but we're gonna try the mic volume, and we're gonna click on start. And so now it's actually going to be taking a audio recording of my voice. That's kind of what it's doing here. It's going to, it says that it is detecting levels. We'll click next. And, oh no, actually, no, we want to let it finish. So I guess we can, I guess we can drag this down to kind of choose like what the best level is going to be, or we can give it time and it can do it itself. So we'll click next. Sure, we'll click yes because we don't really need to actually you know, mess with all that. If you were actually using this program to actually import stuff from old vinyls or, you know, analog tapes, you probably would want to, you know, let it optimize itself, but not really any need for that when I'm just going to be using my voice. So we're going to click on press the record button here, or Alt-R. Now it's going to start recording my voice, and you would obviously have this on for as long as you needed to. And then it says that you can click pause if you want to, you know, change the tape side to like the second side, or change to like a different record or something like that. So we'll click stop. Under advanced, we can choose, or we can actually have it automatically detect and split tracks itself. And we have its, you know, times here that it would use for those. And next, and we can choose to save the track. We'll just call this track one. That's probably okay. We can check this box right here to reduce pops, and we can also check this box to reduce hiss. So we can try that. We can preview, and it'll actually
Alt R. Now it's going to.
It's
start,
actually going to, you know, let us preview it. Obviously, you have this on. Probably not going to be that much difference with my voice, but
Because you know this is on like a like you know stereo headset, so really it's not going to make that much of a difference. We can add copy protection if we want. That's actually really interesting. So this will allow us to, yeah, this will allow it to not be copied essentially. That's actually really interesting. That's like, so yeah, it says that you can add copy protection. That's really interesting. Or we can not add copy protection. So if you didn't want it to be copied again, and it makes you check this box right here, which says that by U.S. and international copyright laws, you're solely responsible for the appropriate use of music that you copy. So yeah, you know, if you obviously copy something that you obtained through non-legal means, then yeah, you're probably going to be, or if you're caught, rather, you're probably going to be, you know, punished for that. But yeah, so yeah, use DRM. That is really interesting. I did not picture this program having that. So yeah, we'll save it to My Music. We'll actually, let's just use DRM because why not? I mean, we can, you know, mess with, or I guess, you know, add copy protection to it. And it's powered by Cool Edit technology right here. So that's kind of cool. Because it's, you know, Cool Edit. And we have successfully transferred music from our analog audio device, not really, to our computer. So we will just click on Start After Recording and finish. Actually, no, I think that was starting another recording. We don't want that. Let's just go into My Music. Keep forgetting how. Yeah, My Documents, My Videos, Music, Track 1.
Here or Alt R.
Yep.
Now it's going to start recording my voice, and you would obviously have this on.
So yeah, there it is. That is a newly generated music file that has DRM on it, which is kind of interesting. So yeah, that is the Plus Analog recorder. Again, not really a optimal demo, not really something that I would be, or I mean, yeah, I'm sure I would find in, you know, like a use for this. I'm sure many of you guys too. I just can't really demo how it would actually work, and probably, you know, copying everything from like an actual vinyl record would probably take a little bit longer, and it'll probably take longer to, like, you know, optimize everything. But it is there, so that is you know, really actually pretty nice. So next we have the Plus Dancer. And I believe what this is it's just a little dancer like person that will like run like on your desktop, and it can kind of just be there while you do work or browse the web or something like that. So let's just kind of see what this is, because I think that I have seen this before, but it was a long time ago. So it has been a while. But if this is what I think it is, or if it's what I remember it being, yeah, it's just this thing where you have this person just dancing on your desktop. It's kind of interesting. It's just here, like you can put it like right here. I don't know. It's like, I guess somebody could find this funny, but it's like if you're trying to do work, I mean, this is kind of. So we can make it stop dancing and it goes away. And we actually have the icon down in our taskbar. It says it's resting, so we can meet the plus dancers here. Looks like it's gonna open up a website, which probably is not. Yeah, we got an internal server error. I'm guessing that's because the web page doesn't exist anymore. This we are on the actual internet now. You know, I made sure to actually connect it properly. As you guys saw, that I was so smart about that before. But so yeah, here's the options. We can change. We only have one dancer. Her name is Amanda, apparently. So. We can choose to run the program when Windows starts. We can keep the dancer on top of other windows, so that's how we are able to like drag it around on top of here. We can automatically detect sound. So, surprise me. Well, there's no other dancers. But let's see if we can actually get more. That'd be interesting. But I really don't know. Same thing. Internal server error. Because yeah, if you go to I think even slash Windows slash plus, yeah, that's not even there anymore. But you know, Microsoft.com/Windows obviously is just going to redirect you to the Windows site. So I guess we're just stuck with the like whatever her name was. It was yeah, Amanda, I just read it, yeah. So we're just stuck with Amanda here. So we're gonna have to, let's see here, let's go back to, I mean, can we like make the actual just start dancing again? So there it is. It's just so like I don't know, it's just it's like kind of like bizarre. I mean, I don't see anybody like what the practical use of this program is. It's just a person dance. I'm sorry, I just don't know what you would use this for, but it is there, so Microsoft obviously has found some use for it. I mean, and we can have it dance only when there's music playing. And apparently, it thinks there's music playing right now because it's dancing. I don't really know why, because there's no music playing. If I actually start playing music.
Here or Alt R, and now it's going to start recording my
Okay,
voice,
now.
and you would obviously have this going
Well,
for a
I guess it
while
doesn't
as
like
you
my
would.
voice because it goes away. Okay, now it comes back again. It comes back again right after we stop playing the what?
Here or Alt R, and now it's going to start.
Okay, that is really odd. Let's just open up. Okay, so that it does the exact opposite of what I wanted to do. It dances when there's no music, and when there is, it doesn't. It's so dance only when music plays. That's what I have it. I only want to dance when music plays. I don't know. Definitely, it's a really interesting program. That I do. Oh, I know why. Because I like. Because okay. So you have to have sound playing while you click this button. I think, then knows when there's sound or not. Basically, because it can't like detect sound on its own. I'm guessing. So, yeah, that is the Plus Dancer, a really bizarre program. Because you got this. I mean, I don't know who they got to do this, but I don't know. It's just really interesting. Very interesting program. We're gonna leave it here for the rest of this video, so we can see how that. I don't know. We're just gonna leave it here for the rest of the video, so this is gonna be here. So try to not pay any like mind to this up here. All right, guys. Well, I think that is going to end it off for this first portion of the Microsoft Plus Digital Media Edition time travel video. Now, this video has gone on to be about an hour long. I think even over an hour long, the actual raw Camtasia file that I made. So I don't really want to go over 30 minutes. I know that 30 minutes is really a long video already for you guys to watch. I don't really want to go over that because that can get really boring. So I'm just going to kind of cut it here at the 30-minute mark, and I'm going to edit the rest of the footage and have it uploaded in part two sometime later this week, or even have it uploaded as next week's video. So be looking out for that. But if you guys liked this video and if you're looking forward to seeing part two, definitely be sure to leave a like, leave a comment down below, leaving what you think of Microsoft Plus. I would, definitely love to hear what you guys have to say about this. And just as always, guys, thank you so much for watching and for all of your amazing support of the channel. And I'm looking forward to seeing you all in the next video.